friends, first of all, let me clarify, I don't celebrate birthdays. But as the birthday is noted in school and in parliament, so right from President of India to Prime Minister to all my colleagues, everybody starts greeting at that too nowadays, you know, social media. So they have put it in the social media, that's why everybody came to know. Even my wife also don't greet me today, because I don't, as I don't have the habit of celebrating birthdays, and moreover I'm not sure whether that is a school birthday or a real birthday, whatever it is. Honorable Minister Sri Bandaru Dattatreya Garu, Kendra Sarkar mein mera saathi, aur Sarma Vibhag ka Mantri Sri Bandaru Dattatreya Ji, aur Telangana Pradesh ka Vitta Mantri Sri Itala Rajendra Ji, aur Hyderabad branch ka Adhyaksha Sri Changal Reddy Garu, aur Vice Chairman Southern Region Sri Adisumali Venkateswarrao Garu, our Sri Chinnamastan Garu, Regional Committee Member, Sri C.A. Bhavanarayan Rao Garu, Hyderabad Branch Secretary, our Amara Kendra Sarkar Ka Yahaka Chief Commissioner of Central Excise and Customs Hyderabad, GST Zone, Sri Sandeep Bhatnagarji, our Aaj, Ye Sthapana Divas Ke Avasar Par Itana Bhari Sankhya Mein Aaye Hue Sabhi Sadasya Gan Mitro, brothers and sisters and my young friends, I am mee andariki naa meeda choopichina abhimananiki hrudayapoorvaka dhanyavaadalu. Mee janmadinamu naa janmadinamu rendu oke kaavadam edundo adi santoshakaramaina vishayam ainappudiki kuda nenu meeru janmadinam జరుపుకుందాం. ఎందుకంటే మీరు ఒక ఉత్తమమైన కార్యక్రమం కోసం, సమాజంలో చైతన్యం తేవడం కోసం మీరందరూ ప్రయత్నం చేస్తూ ఉన్నారు. అందుకని ఈ శుభ సందర్భంగా మీ అందరికీ నా హృదయపూర్వక హార్దికమైన అభినందనలు. మై కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్ అండ్ కాంప్లిమెంట్స్ టు ఆల్ ద చార్టర్డ్ అకౌంటెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా. ఇట్స్ ఎ వెరీ నోబుల్ ప్రొఫెషన్, ఇట్స్ ఎ వెరీ యూజ్ఫుల్ ప్రొఫెషన్, ఇట్స్ ఎ వెరీ ఎన్లైటెడ్ ప్రొఫెషన్. The profession is engaging itself in the service of the nation by giving the needed information, because I always believe information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. Information with confirmation is more than an ammunition, because information with confirmation, you can fight against corruption, you can fight against discrimination, you can fight against inequalities, you can fight against other social discrimination and also the other social evils that are there in society. That's why information is more important. You people, by working hard, by studying hard, then you have acquired this knowledge, and this information, if you pass it on to the people along with the confirmation, that will be very useful for the national transformation. Friends, the Prime Minister gave us a three-line mantra. He told all of us, three-line mantra: reform, perform and transform. He is the modern transformer of India. He wants to build a new India. He wants to build a India where there is no hunger, where there is no poverty, where there is no unemployment, where there is no discrimination, where there is no exploitation, where the economic disparities are brought down. That is the new India, where the younger generation have ample opportunities and everybody should feel that they are part of the developmental story. Samaj mein har ek vyakti ko aisa bhavana aana chahiye ki desh ke vikas mein wo bhi bhagidari hai, unko bhi kuch na kuch mil rahe, aisa bhavana desh mein paida karna pradhanmantri ka mukhya uddesh hai, lakshya hai. Ee deshamlo ee samajamlo na pedda vaallu chinna vaallu andaru kuda మేము కూడా ఈ అభివృద్ధిలో ఒక భాగస్వామ్యం. ఈ ప్రభుత్వం చేపట్టే అభివృద్ధి కార్యక్రమాలు మాకు కూడా అందుతున్నాయనే ఒక భావన. అభివృద్ధి ఫలాలు అందరికీ అందాలి, ఆర్థిక అసమానతలు తగ్గాలి, ప్రాంతీయ అసమానతలు పోవాలి, సాంఘిక వివక్షత పోవాలి. ప్రతి ఒక్కరు కూడా ఉత్సాహంతో ముందుకు వెళ్ళాలి. అందరం కలిసి శక్తివంతమైన భారతదేశాన్ని తయారు చేయాలా. ఆ శక్తివంతమైన భారతదేశం అంటే ఆకలి దప్పులు లేని, ఆకలి దప్పులు లేని, అవినీతికి తావు లేని, అక్రమానికి చోటు లేని, వివక్షతకు అవకాశం లేనింటి యొక్క అందరికీ సరైన అవకాశాలు వాళ్ళ శక్తిని బట్టి, వాళ్ళ ఓర్పును బట్టి, వాళ్ళ నేర్పును బట్టి, వాళ్ళకి కావాల్సిన యొక్క కూర్పును అందించి తద్వారా సమాజంలో మార్పులు ఇచ్చేటటువంటి విధంగా ఈ దేశాన్ని మార్చాలనేది ప్రధానమంత్రి నరేంద్ర మోడీ గారి యొక్క ఉద్దేశం. దాంట్లో భాగంగానే నిన్న అంటే ఇవాళ ఉదయాన్నే మనం అందరం కూడా చేపట్టిన దేశ యొక్క చరిత్రాత్మకుడి యొక్క ది రెవల్యూషనరీ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, ది జిఎస్టీ ఇస్ ద రెవల్యూషనరీ ట్యాక్సేషన్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇన్ ఇండియాస్ హిస్టరీ. 70 ఇయర్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఇండిపెండెన్స్, 17 ఇయర్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఇట్ వాజ్ ఫస్ట్ ప్రపోజ్డ్ డ్యూరింగ్ శ్రీ అటల్ బిహారీ వాజ్పేయి గవర్నమెంట్, ఇండియా ఫైనలీ గాట్ ఏ గుడ్ అండ్ సింపుల్ ట్యాక్స్. గుడ్ అండ్ సింపుల్ ట్యాక్స్, జిఎస్టీ మీన్స్ గుడ్ సింపుల్ ట్యాక్స్ and is otherwise known as goods and service tax. At the stroke of midnight yesterday night in parliament, all of us parliamentarians belonging to different political parties, all of us joined together, gathered in the central hall of the parliament in the presence of the honorable president of India Sri Pranab Mukherjee ji, vice president Hamid Ansari ji, and the prime minister Narendra Modi, speaker of the Lok Sabha, and the finance minister, all of us joined together. And then at 12:01 the GST is launched in the country. I am very happy it is receiving overwhelming response across the country, because this is the transformation that is required. 17 years of hard work, three governments of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Manmohan Singh and Narendra Modi, they all worked together and then they exchanged ideas. There were wider consultation with the states and also with political parties, with also the associations across the country, various stakeholders, and then the present GST has come. So it's a culmination of the combined efforts of all the political leadership of the country and the administrative, the bureaucrats of the country, and also the industry and stakeholders. It's a combined culmination of the collective wisdom of the people of the country. The GST is on. I don't say there are no problems. There will be initial hiccups. There will be some problems also. Any transformation of this big nature, there are bound to be some hiccups. But country, people of the country are ready to go through this system and go for a transformation. I am confident. Same thing was said when demonetization and remonetization has been taken place. People said it will be a failure. People are angry. People are hungry for development. They are not angry with the government. There is a hunger. Hunger for development after 70 years. Why these disparities? Why this exploitation? Why this evasion? Why this black money? All these questions were raised. I am really saluting the ordinary people of the country. 50 days they suffered. They stood in queue to draw their own money. But at the end of the day, they all stood by the decision of the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, because they believed Modi want to transform India. Modi want to stop the black money. And I am happy, and I would like to compliment the role played by chartered accountants and your institution during the course of demonetization also. It's praiseworthy, and I compliment all of you for the great role you have played in educating the society. Kuch log mazak uda rahe, kya hua sir, pura paisa bank mein aaya, 15 lakh rupaya, 16 lakh rupaya, ha bank mein aaya paisa, pehle jo bedroom mein tha, bathroom mein tha, जो पिल्लो के नीचे था वो बैंक में पहुंच गया, और बैंक में पहुंचते समय पैसा के साथ पता, पैसा के साथ पिता, पैसा के साथ उनका पति कौन है, वो जानकारी के साथ बैंक में पहुंच गया. द मनी हैज कम विथ एड्रेस. सो नाउ द रिजर्व बैंक इज बैंक्स एंड ऑल दे आर ऑल एनालाइजिंग व्हाट इज ब्लैक एंड व्हाट इज व्हाइट. सो द मनी हैज कम बैक एंड रीच द डेस्टिनेशन. सिमिलरली माई फ्रेंड्स, this GST is going to do wonders. It's going to create a win-win situation, because 17 taxes on goods and services resulting in different taxes at different locations. Even though as a nation we are one, how can there be so many taxes in so many different rates for one nation? So one nation, one tax was the long felt need and the aspiration, and finally it became a reality from today. It's a very happy moment that happens to be your foundation day. Accordingly, the 1st July of 2017 has acquired as much significance as the 15th August 1947 in the history of the country. These two dates are the most transformative landmarks in the history of modern India. The period of 70 years and 17 years I referred in the starting has some significance. They only underline the fact that we Indians are slow in collectively deciding on the major issues. Communist China stole the march over socialist India by taking up economic reforms 20 years ahead of us, communist China. When we became independent, we were ahead of China in respect of all economic parameters. But today, we are significantly behind them. This is where we need introspection. The much delayed launch of GST offers such a moment of introspection for all of us. Experts have been saying GST would have increased our GDP by 1.5 to 2%. That means a huge economic upliftment. This amounts to a huge impact in terms of economic growth and opportunities for the millions of aspiring young Indians. But still, we kept on dithering and delaying, thereby losing substantial time and opportunities. Still better late than never, and finally the GST is a reality from today. Some people are saying, why don't you postpone for some more time? Postponement. Postponement means you are postponing the future of India, you are postponing the development of India, you are postponing the aspiration of the younger generation. Modi is not there to postpone. Modi has come here to prepone. Modi, aur log bhi kehte hai na, ye to Pradhan Mantri sote nahi, kisi ko sone dete nahi. He doesn't sleep and he do not allow others to sleep. That's one comment by some people. Aur dusra comment bhi hai, ye Pradhan Mantri khate nahi, kisi ko khane dete nahi. Khate nahi mane khana nahi. Maggie nahi, baggy nahi khate, yehi hai to unke bare mein. So friends, this GST also is an important element to arrest corruption, to stop black money, to stop evasion of taxes. It's an important aspect one should really remember. Friends, there has been a debate and a discussion on GST over the 17 years, starting with economists, then taxation experts, then intellectuals, then socio-political analysts, even among the common people. People need to be made to fully understand the causes and the consequence of such major transformational initiative, and this is the need of the hour. I am happy that the Hyderabad chapter of ICAI has taken this initiative on the very first day of GST coming into force. I am happy various branches across the country are holding meetings, brainstorming sessions, educating the youngsters so that they can go and educate the people. Because everybody has to learn, including ministers also. And ministers are not experts. You are experts at least. So everybody has to learn. I say ministers should learn more. And I always say, learn, not yearn for the minister. I am not telling you not to yearn. You are learning and also earning. The ministers also has to learn. Friends, even after so many years of debate, discussion, at the stroke of launch of GST, some sections of the society, including some political class, are still raising some issues and doubts about this game-changing, good and simple tax. Some people could not participate in yesterday's function. They are feeling that they are more comfortable. Isolation seems to be their consolation. They must join the national mainstream. As I told you, it's a collective effort of all. It's not a product of Narendra Modi or Arun Jaitley. It's a product of the collective consultation of all the states and the center. It's a collective consultation between Chandrasekhar Rao and Arun Jaitley and Prime Minister. And it's E.T.L. Rajendra and Arun Jaitley. And then every state for Chandrababu Naidu or the Venamala Ramakrishnadu or the Tamil Nadu. It is either EPS or OPS, all have supported this. So that's the mood of the nation. All assemblies have unanimously passed the resolution. Parliament has also passed the resolution by two-thirds majority. Parliament by two-thirds, assemblies unanimously. Then where is the question of anything? Yes, there will be some problems. In every transformation, there will be problems. తెలుగులో మాట చెప్తారు కదా, మన మామూలు భాష అర్థం చేసుకోవాలంటే పురిటి నొప్పులు ఉంటాయి కొన్ని. ఆ పురిటి నొప్పులకు కూడా ఉపశమనం ఉంటుంది. ఈవెన్ బిఫోర్ డెలివరీ దెర్ బి సమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్, దట్స్ క్వైట్ న్యాచురల్. సో ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ అన్సర్మౌంటబుల్. దెర్ బి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్, ద కమిషనర్ వాజ్ జస్ట్ టెలింగ్ మీ దెర్ ఆర్ సమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. దెర్ బి సమ్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆల్సో, దెర్ ఆర్ సమ్ రిక్వెస్ట్ మేడ్ బై తెలంగాణ గవర్నమెంట్, సమ్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆర్ మేడ్ బై ఆంధ్ర గవర్నమెంట్, డిఫరెంట్ స్టేట్ గవర్నమెంట్స్ ఆర్ మేకింగ్. ఇట్స్ ఎ ప్రాసెస్, ఇట్స్ నాట్ వన్ డే అఫేర్. జిఎస్టీ నౌ పార్లమెంట్ హెస్ గివన్ పవర్ టు జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్, అసెంబ్లీస్ హెవ్ గివన్ పవర్ టు జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్. హూ ఈజ్ జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్? జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్ ఇస్ ఎ మెకానిజం ఎవాల్వ్డ్ బై ది కాన్స్టిట్యూషన్ అమెండ్మెంట్, వైర్ యూ హ్యావ్ రిప్రజెంటేటివ్ ఆఫ్ ఎవ్రీ స్టేట్. ఆల్ స్టేట్స్ ఆర్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ దేర్. దే విల్ డిస్కస్ అమంగ్ దెమ్ సెల్స్, దే విల్ కమ్ టు కంక్లూజన్ యునానిమస్లీ, ఆర్ దే విల్ కమ్ టు కంక్లూజన్ బై 2/3 మెజారిటీ. దట్స్ ద ఫైనెస్ట్ సిస్టమ్ దట్ వీ హావ్ బీన్ ఏబుల్ టు ఎవాల్వ్. సో ఎనీ డిస్కషన్ ఎస్టర్డే ద జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్ ఇన్ 18th మీటింగ్ have reduced the price on fertilizer, brought it down to 5% for the farming community of the country. దేశంలోని రైతుల కోసం ఎరువుల పైన విధించినట్టు యొక్క స్లాబ్ అయితే ఉందని 5% తీసుకొచ్చారు. అలాగే ట్రాక్టర్ యొక్క వాటికి స్పేర్ పార్ట్స్ పైన ఉన్నదాన్ని 12% తీసుకొచ్చారు. అలాగే రాబోయే రోజుల్లో జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్ ఇట్స్ కలెక్టివ్ విజ్డమ్ కెన్ డిస్కస్ ఇష్యూస్ అండ్ కమ్ టు కంక్లూడర్స్. ఫ్రెండ్స్, ది సమ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ సెయింగ్ కంట్రీ ఈజ్ నాట్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ ఫర్ జిఎస్టీ. ఐ డోంట్ అగ్రీ విత్ దెమ్. That proposed GST is imperfect, that there are so many taxes through it supposed to be one tax, and GST rate structure will increase prices. This is a misinformation, disinformation, wrong information without confirmation some people are trying to pass on. Friends, the need of the hour is to address such wrong perceptions. So the task before us is essentially a communication challenge, and you are the great communicators because you have ability, you have understanding, you have knowledge of the subject also. I would now like to reflect on these four issues. To begin with, let us understand, if the country is not prepared for GST, even when we finally won political independence under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, there were some people who questioned if India was ready. 1947, when we were about to get independence, some people said India is not ready, we have a number of illiterates, we have poor people, what will they do with regard to freedom and all. Such skeptical people were there. Given the levels of illiteracy, poverty, gender inequality and social diversity, many Western commentators even said India would not see the second general election. This is what they said. But every time we are having successful general elections, and we are the largest democracy in the world, we feel proud of the same. We have proved such gloomy forecast and prophecies wrong. We are now a shining and the largest democracy of the world. We feel proud of the same. The question that I would like to raise, should we wait for some more years to be ruled by Britishers till everyone was convinced that yes, India was ready? Was it the purpose at that time? So the argument now also seems to be similar nature. Friends, secondly, it is being said some sections of the trade and industry are not still ready to shift to the new tax regime. For long, we have been talking about GST for the last 6 months. The government has been saying the GST will be rolled out from the 1st of this July. And the government, in right earnest, for a long time, even before the GST Act was approved by the Parliament, has been working on the technology-backed structures required for implementing GST regime. It seems to be in our nature that we don't anticipate things to come, and even if we do, we don't volunteer to prepare for the change. It has generally come to be our habit that we act only when there is no other option. Preparing for the GST regime is not a big task, and particularly when IT tools are available easily to do so. In any case, over 70% to 75% of the taxpayers have already got themselves registered on the GSTN, Goods and Services Technology Network. So it is not correct to say that the government has not given them sufficient time. 17 years is not an ordinary time. ఇలాపల పిల్లలు గుట్టుంటారు, వాళ్ళకి మీసాలు కూడా వచ్చి ఉంటాయి. ఫ్రెండ్స్, సెకండరీ, దోస్ హు ఆర్ నాట్ రెడీ వుడ్ నెవర్ బి రెడీ. దోస్ హు ఆర్ నాట్ రెడీ వుడ్ నెవర్ బి రెడీ ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ దేవర్ గివన్ ఇయర్ మోర్. ఇన్ ఎనీ కేస్, గవర్నమెంట్ హెస్ రిలాక్స్ ద టైమ్ ఫ్రేమ్ ఫర్ సచ్ పీపుల్ టు ఫైల్ దేర్ రిటర్న్స్ టిల్ సెప్టెంబర్. దేర్ ఇస్ టైమ్ టిల్ సెప్టెంబర్ టు ఫైల్ దేర్ రిటర్న్స్. సో నథింగ్ టు వరీ ఆన్ దట్ కౌంట్. సో ద గవర్నమెంట్ డిడ్ ఇట్స్ బెస్ట్ to get all the concerned ready for GST. In fact, they are ready. The few others will definitely get ready soon, so this is not an issue. The second criticism is proposed GST structure is not perfect. This is a vague and illogical criticism. Perfection is not a static concept. It is an ever-evolving dynamic concept. What is perfect today may not be so tomorrow. As with more learning from the experience and with more technologies options, we may reach a new normal. There is a saying, wise men learn from others' experience and fools learn from their own experience. Indian people are wise men, they will learn from others' experience. Don't worry on that count. The approved GST rate structure with 5 slabs of taxation is certainly perfect in the sense that it is the outcome of collective wisdom of the country as embodied in the GST Council. Ultimate aim is one nation, one tax. We are moving in that direction. We are moving in that direction with economic disparities, with different conditions, with different states. You cannot have overnight one rate, one slab for everything. We have to take care of the problems and also the inequalities. That's why these 5 slabs have come. Friends, the third issue is there are many tax rates which will study, which will be ideal thing will be one. It's a common knowledge that a wide range of goods and services are used by a range of people belonging to a range of socio-economic categories with varying income levels and paying categories. So, single rate structure is illogical and untenable. You cannot have same rate. Can you have same rate for an Indian-made foreign IMFL, imported foreign liquor, and also BD? Can you have same rate? You cannot. Because capacity, affordability of the people, their habits and their consumption and their essential, these are all important aspects. So friends, a national taxation system should aim at redistribution of income